After completing this tutorial, you will be able to evaluate popular sources such as websites so that you can determine their quality and relevance to your research. In Evaluating Sources Part 1, you learned about the five main criteria for evaluating sources: relevance, evidence, currency, authority, and purpose. While the first tutorial showed how the criteria apply to a scholarly article, this tutorial will apply them to a website. Let's get started. Websites may not be as clear-cut as traditionally published sources, like books and scholarly articles. Imagine you're researching the impact of reintroducing wolves into Yellowstone National Park. And in the process of searching, you found a website that discusses the topic. How might we use the RECAP evaluation criteria to assess a source like a website? When first considering whether a popular source is relevant, you may first need to consider the requirements of your assignment. What counts as evidence, and how might you use the source? For instance, if you have been asked to use only scholarly sources, then this website would not be relevant. But there may be other times where a popular source is relevant to your research. What about evidence? Popular sources tend not to have clear bibliographies or works cited pages, but they often show their sources in the body of the article. This article, in particular, mentions Doug Smith and the Yellowstone Wolf Project. It also mentions a research project from the U.S. Geological Survey in Fort Collins, among other sources. These references show you what information the author was using and may point you to additional resources. On to currency. For this source, the publication date is easily identifiable. But if you are struggling to find the date, look at the footer of the website to see if the date of last update is listed there. In terms of authority, we need to learn more about the author. We can start by clicking on the author's name and seeing what the publication says about them. If that doesn't provide sufficient information, then we can search the author's name online to see what else they have written and what their credentials are. Finally, we need to consider the purpose. As with our scholarly example, we should be able to discern this to a degree by reading the article itself. However, with websites, we should also consider the website's purpose as a whole by consulting its About Us page. From here, we should be able to learn more about the website's aims, its intended audience, and its purpose. So let's recap one last time. Whenever you are considering using a source for your research, remember to evaluate for relevance, evidence, currency, authority, and purpose. By putting all of these criteria together, you'll be better equipped to evaluate any source. This concludes part 2 of our introduction to evaluating sources. If you would like additional information on this topic, or have any questions, please ask us at library.georgetown.edu/ask-us or email us at reference@georgetown.edu.